Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name's Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW Blue Plan. It's Friday, so it's weigh-in day. So I'm here to share with you kind of how my week went, what my goals are for this next week. We're going to talk all about the WW workshop topic and of course I'm going to share my weigh-in with you. But before we get started, if you're new to my channel, please stick around and subscribe. Turn the bell on next to it so you're notified whenever new videos are uploaded. Like I mentioned, I do weigh-ins every single Friday, so you don't wanna miss out. And of course, if you love these videos, I'd appreciate a big thumbs up. It really helps out my channel, and of course, it means a lot to me. And make sure you're checking out that description box down below where you're going to find my nutrition coaching website. I actually just modified that a little bit, and now I'm offering 30-minute and 60-minute one-on-one coaching sessions and macro and calorie calculation, which is so, so incredibly important to know exactly what you should be eating every day. So check out my website and take advantage of those services. You'll also find links, discount codes to all my favorite things, as well as the link to head on over and join us on my Facebook group. It's a growing community that's loving and supportive, and we'd love to have you. So now let's jump into this week's WW workshop topic and weigh in. Let's talk first about my week. So I had, as always, a really, really busy week. Like I've mentioned before, real estate has just really picked up for me. So I'm spending a lot more time on real estate as well as maintaining my nutrition coaching and two YouTube channels. So it's been busy. And because of the election on Tuesday, I didn't go to Jazzercise. So I actually have only been to Jazzercise once so far this week. But I'm going today, Friday, tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday, and Monday. So for the next 4 days in a row, kind of to make up for this last week. There just isn't enough hours in the day sometime. But as far as my eating went, it went okay. You guys, losing weight's hard. It's hard to stay motivated. It's hard to stay committed. It's hard to make it a top priority when so many other things in life sometimes just get in the way. So I would say that my eating was like 60-40 this last week. 60% where it needed to be in my calories, my points, my macros. 40% a little lackluster. A little on the struggle bus, but that's okay. Some weeks are better than others. And like I said, dieting is hard. Who's with me on that one? But my week was good. My week was busy. And overall, I had a good week. I really truly have not a whole lot to complain about. So before I get into my weigh-in and next week's goals, let's talk about this week's workshop topic. So as I've mentioned the last couple of weeks, WW is doing kind of a fan favorite series where they're going back and revisiting some of the WW workshop topics that people have really, really enjoyed and requested to be revisited. So this week's topic is talk to yourself like you would talk to a friend. And I think that this is so important. We're definitely much, much harder on ourselves than we would be on a loved one, a friend, a coworker, a fellow WWer, if they were struggling the same way that we're struggling. Maybe they're not losing weight. Maybe they're gaining weight. Maybe they are struggling staying on track. We would be much easier on them than we are on ourselves. It's okay to have a setback. It's okay to gain weight. It's okay to screw up. It's okay. We need to give ourselves grace, especially in the state of our world right now with the global pandemic and just the stress of everything going on. Give yourself a little bit of grace. And maybe, like I said, for you, it's not your top priority. Like it was for me this last week, it just couldn't be my top priority. We just need to be kind to ourselves and talk nicely to ourselves and support ourselves just like we would someone else. So the next time you're struggling, think about how you would support a friend who is also struggling. And I'm going to share three tips with you from WW on how to be a little bit nicer to yourself. So tip number one is if a friend came to you and said that she's struggling, that she's had quite a few slip-ups and she knows she's not gonna see a pretty number on the scale, what would you say to her? What tone of voice would you use and what words would you say? You might say something like, you're being way too hard on yourself. Slip-ups are normal, it's okay, just get back on track. So the next time you have a slip-up or you go off track, tell yourself the same thing. So scenario number two, your friend comes to you and says, I pre-tracked all of my food for this party that I went to and I overindulged when I got there and I feel horrible that I overindulged when I got there. Again, what would you say to her and what tone of voice would you use? You'd encourage her, you'd tell her it's okay. You'd tell her that life happens and it's okay to go enjoy herself at the party and just pick up and get right back on track. But on the flip side, what would you say to yourself if this was you? You'd say something like, ugh, I can never commit to anything. I'm never gonna lose this weight. I'm such a failure. So think about that. Think about the difference between what you would say to a friend versus what you would say to yourself in this exact situation. And number three is think about these two scenarios. So the first scenario, your friend came to you and said she was struggling, you encouraged her and you supported her. Now the second situation, your friend came to you and said she overindulged and you encouraged her and you supported her. But what if it was you in both of these situations? I think it's more likely that you would say to yourself, the example in number two, about how you screwed up and you're a failure and you're never gonna lose this weight. And if that is you, you really need to change the way that you talk to yourself. Think about what you said to your friend, and that's what you should be saying to yourself. We're humans. We're not gonna have perfect journeys. We're going to have peaks and valleys, ups and downs, weight gains, weight losses, maintenance. It's all going to happen. Life happens. And sometimes weight loss isn't our top priority. And you just need to, again, give yourself a little grace, cut yourself a little slack. And next time you're starting to beat yourself up, think about if it was you outside of your body coming to you with the same situation, what would you say? And really, again, just try to be mindful of how we talk to ourselves. It's really important to talk to ourselves positively because that produces positive results. So I like this topic. I think it's definitely something we all struggle with. I know that I beat myself up when I make mistakes. I've gotten a lot better throughout losing weight, but I still catch myself beating myself up. And I know that it's okay. And one slip up, one piece of cake, one extra slice of pizza isn't going to make you gain all your weight back. Chances are you may not even gain weight that week. So just give yourself some grace and be kind to yourself. So now let's talk about my weigh-in. Like I said, I'd say 60-40 last week as far as my week. But when I stepped on the scale today, I'm down 0.6. Now I should have, and here I am, maybe not being positive to myself, but I'm gonna phrase this in a way that has a positive spin. I am 1 pound, or was 1 pound away from hitting 50 pounds lost last week. I lost 0.6 this week, so now I'm 0.4 away. So yay me for losing 0.6, yay me for being 0.4 away. But I wish that I could have took off that last pound to hit 50 pounds lost. But with that being said, it's just a little extra motivation for this next week to stay on track and take off the measly 0.4 pounds to hit my 50 pounds. So see how I could have beaten myself up over that and really been discouraged and bummed out and down on myself. But instead, I'm taking it as motivation to get the last stinking 0.4 off for next week's weigh-in. So that's kind of how you can take a potentially negative self-talk situation and turn it positive. So this next week's goals are to kill it at Jazzercise. I think I have 5 or 6 classes scheduled. So that's amazing. It'll make up for this last week. And of course, to just stay on my nutrition game. Hit my protein goal, stay within my calories, watch my points, do all the right things so that next week I can come to you and say I lost 50 pounds. So I'm really excited for that. So now I wanna hear from you guys. How was your week? Did you guys struggle? Did you do well? Is losing weight hard? Tell me if you are with me on losing weight is hard. And of course, leave those comments down below. I love hearing from you guys and interacting with you guys. And also think about next time you negative self-talk, what can you do to turn that around? So again, thank you guys so much for watching. If you are new, make sure that you're subscribed and your bell's turned on. Of course, we would love, love to have you. Check out that description box again for nutrition coaching, as well as discounts and links to my favorite things in my Facebook group. And last but not least, before we go, give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And happy Friday, my friends. Hang in there. Let's be positive to others and ourselves. And I'll see you next time. Bye.